Globally, cervical cancer is the fourth most frequent cancer in women, with an estimated 604,000 new cases every year and 342,000 deaths. Here in Uganda, cervical cancer is the commonest cancer in women, with about 6,950 women diagnosed with the disease and about 4,607 dying from the disease every year. This has been blamed on a number of factors, among which are the low uptake of the HPV vaccines by teenage girls, late detection mechanisms, among others.
Cancer of the cervix is the commonest cancer in Uganda when you put all cancers together. In the year of 2020, 6,959 women were diagnosed with cervical cancer in this country. Now, that is close to actually 7,000 women, and it's accounted for over 20% of all cancers in this country put together. Men, women, children, everyone. So that's how common cancer of the cervix is. It also accounted for over 35% of all cancers in women. So that's why it's important for everyone, men and women, to really take the issue of cancer of the cervix as an emergency.
When it comes to cancer, cancer of the cervix is taking lead. Many of our women are dying as a result of cancer of the cervix. And what we have noted is that many of our people get health facilities when it is very late. So there is delay in screening.
Cervical cancer is caused by the human papillomavirus, which can be transmitted from one person to another through sexual intercourse. However, the virus can be prevented through immunization with the HPV vaccine. It is upon this background that parents are urged to take their girls between 10 to 14 years for vaccination and ensure that they complete all the two doses for full protection.
One is at risk of suffering from cancer of the cervix as long as this woman is sexually active, because the virus that is high risk for cancer of the cervix, that we now say is a cause for cancer of the cervix, human papilloma virus, is sexually transmitted. That's why it's also important to make sure that we have our girls vaccinated. The government of Uganda is vaccinating girls who are 10 years of age against the human papilloma virus, which causes cancer of the cervix. If we did away with cancer of the cervix, you can imagine we would save 20% of all the patients succumbing to cancer would survive. So that's how big it is a problem. And I usually tell people that in countries like United Kingdom, USA, Netherlands, cancer of the cervix is not one of the top cancers in those countries, because they embraced vaccination.
Dr. Noleb further explained some of the risk factors to the cancer of the cervix.
Risk factors that increase this woman's risk of developing cancer of the cervix: tobacco use, smoking, multiple sexual partners, because when a woman has many sexual partners, they are likely to get different types of human papillomavirus, because human papillomavirus has over 100 types. There are a few of them that are high risk or that are very aggressive in causing cancer of the cervix.
Women of childbearing age are encouraged to always go for cervical cancer screening at least once in every 3 years, while those living with HIV/AIDS should do so every year. Meanwhile, the Uganda Women Cancer Support Organization, together with the Ministry of Health, held a stakeholders meeting on Child Health and African Vaccination Week, with a major objective of creating awareness of the HPV vaccination. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.